Alright, so just arrived at the Lena Pillars.
Alright, so we're the 14th of August. It's 8:24 a.m. Me and some friends are gonna go to the Lena Pillars once again to see how it's like in summer.
I'll be sleeping in the car, so I'll just see you there, I think.
Summer is here, and it's time to go back to Yakutia's most famous site, the Lena Pillars. As I've been told countless times, but it's arguably even more beautiful than its frozen version.
This is my breakfast.
I'll be accompanied by two students and a Yakut friend who has lent us a car. The thing is, it's a completely different story to get there compared to winter, especially if you want to avoid relying on an overpriced tour and they're reaching there by your own means. But before we get to the really difficult part, the melting of the snow unveils some very interesting sights on the way that we couldn't visit before.
Let's get closer.
If you saw a video about summer in Yakutsk, you'd probably remember Rafting, the place where the massive Hitchhiking festival takes place. Well, actually, every district in the Republic has at least one spot dedicated for the festivities, and this is one of them. That was then the occasion to learn a bit more about the Yakut culture.
So you can see this circle thingy at the back. That's where people stand to do the welcoming the sun thing. And that's also a calendar from what I've been told, where like every gate represents a month. It's getting colder already. Like last week we still had like 30 degrees. Today I think the maximum is gonna be somewhere around 15 to 18 degrees.
Да, три метра.
И сейчас мы.
Мы сейчас в среднем.
Средний, да.
Орто дойду, то есть это означает средний мир. В среднем мире мы живем, в нижнем мире живут, ну ты понимаешь. И в верхнем мире живут боги.
Yeah, so from what I could gather, so Alonjo is like the name of a ritual that's like happening here. So during the festivities, it's like consisting of like half an hour, 1 hour, sometimes 2 hours, just reading, dancing, kind of like a ritual to celebrate these three worlds. So this is like one of the typical Yakut house. This is called a balavan, which is different from the ponty one. This is a bit colder in the summer and a bit warmer in winter compared to other types of traditional houses. The wall is like just like one layer. I'm pretty sure it's way too cold for me in winter here.
Alright, back on the road. So we're here in Orto Doidu, and the Lena Pillars are over there. In winter, it's pretty straightforward, as you only need to keep driving until Bulgun Yaktar and start driving on the frozen river. Just be sure to have enough gas, as you don't want to be stuck here by minus 40 degrees. In summer, the cheapest tour would take you by car to the same village, then on a speedboat to the Pillars. But you still have to count about 28,300 rubles for a maximum of 4 people. So what if you want to go there by yourself? Well, if you manage to reach Titari, since you're way closer to the Pillars, you can ask a local to take you there for way cheaper. But look, see the problem here? That's right, there are no paved roads.
So we've been driving for quite a while, and here's another really bumpy section. Hopefully we can get there.
So you have to make your way on a very rocky and bumpy path for about 60 kilometers, with barely any signs indicating whether you're on the right track or not. It's very easy to take a wrong turn, which we eventually did.
So apparently you just went the wrong way. So we've been driving on this very, very bad road like for so long, and I have to cross this shit again. Yep.
So after hours and hours of uncertainty, we eventually reached Titari.
We finally reach our very small village called Titari. Looking for the guy that's gonna take us to the Pillars that are a bit further down the river. Oh, up the river. I think that's that guy over here. So yeah, that's like a very small world, that's why it's so cheap. We have like a 40-minute trip, more or less. So it's my first time going there in summer. The good thing about summer compared to winter is that you can see the Pillars like from the beginning all the way to the viewpoint. Because in winter, like all of this is like covered in ice, and the road is like only all the way back there, so you can only see this part like from very far.
As we went on, the pillars started appearing, only growing bigger and bigger, and they were more and more beautiful to look at. As this region experiences a change of temperature between winter and summer of up to 100 degrees, the yearly extreme freezing and thawing slowly chipped the softer parts of the rock formations over millions of years, offering a landscape only Yakutia would have been able to create. With its beautiful shades of color in summer, or its Game of Thrones-like resemblance in winter, this is one of the most unique places Russia has to offer, and it really deserves its spot as a UNESCO World Heritage Site.
Alright, so we just arrived. I think I'm already starting to like this more than winter, as the travel by boat, you really get to witness like the huge size and length of the pillars. When in winter, you just like get here straight away. I was just like blown away by the whole thing the whole time. Back in winter, it took us like roughly an hour to go up there, but right now we have like lighter clothes. It's not sleepy or anything, so I think it's gonna take like maybe half of that. Alright, see you there.
Now it's time to go up. And that's where the real fun comparing summer and winter begins.
5:25, the walk starts.
Steven, il fait, et là il fait,
sure?
Il fait comme ça.
I'm already out of breath. I've gotten so fat. It's funny how like even though like the winter lasts so long, like the flowers and the plants just still bloom like this. Last time there was like no path right here, it was just like you could walk anywhere. Now there's like a clear path in front of me. So. Something that didn't cross our mind last time is that you can see there's a cross on the rock right there. For some reason last time I didn't think about how did it get here. If you fall, that's like a 300 meters fall, so... Alright, so here we are at the top. I mean, if you only go to this place, maybe winter's a bit better because you get to see like the everything being white and all like the river being frozen. But just like adding this to the trip by boat, by the rest of the pillars, is like a whole new experience. I think both are really worth doing. The view is so breathtaking.
And then it was time to go back. The view on the pillars as the sun went down was just as beautiful and will probably stay in my memory forever. Even though this trip was a bit challenging to organize, not relying on a tour cost us only about 2,000 rubles per person for both the gas and the trip by boat. It was definitely worth coming back in summer to rediscover this place in a completely different look. It's nearly impossible to recommend one over the other, but let me know in the comments which one you think looks the most impressive. If you're wondering why Steven wasn't part of his trip, he was on a hitchhike adventure that you can already find a video about. And as always, be sure to leave a like and subscribe so you won't miss what's coming up next. See you in the next video!
Alright guys, going out of character for a bit. As you probably don't know, Yakutia has been on fire for several weeks now. Wildfires are very common during this time of year, but right now this is one of the worst in years or even decades. Many people, including myself, feel it's not really talked about enough in Russia also, let alone in the rest of the world. So I'm taking the opportunity to bring it into light a little, as even the Lena Pillars are having it very rough right now. So if you got some time, just check the hashtag right there. And hopefully it can finally get the attention it deserves. And yeah, that's pretty much it. See ya.